right.
That was close.
I know.
We almost lost like something over there.
I want to bring your left hand a little bit forward. Let's do one with your nose.
Here I stand,
victorious.
What is this?
Probably Williams.
Sorry.
Well, that's a bad one.
I know such a good thing.
If you want to bring it.
It's very English.
What happens when you forget to bring a boom box?
Oh, I have it.
At the mercy of someone's iPod.
You want to hear it over?
Sure.
Okay. I can reach stereophonics on the way.
Not so serious, just kind of like loosen up a little bit.
Sorry guys, we've heard it a thousand times.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah.
I miss you, just kind of a little snappy smile. Oh wait, wait, that's it right here.
Oh yeah, that's it. Thank you so much.
You know, let's try holding with your legs forward and just kind of dress falling in between.
It is all okay. I mean, there's no more. It's not actually
happening. Okay, never mind. You're good.
We are rolling.
Let's do it.
We're doing it.
Shut up.
Dressed very beautiful, fitting with the whole feel.
What?
Something okay. Kind of cool and vintage looking about that.
Yeah. No, we're mixing it up today.
Yeah.
Here in the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. All right. So actually, talk about being here in this house. How much of this house are you familiar with, and the Double Indemnity history and all that kind of stuff?
Oh, actually, somebody should have briefed me, because you saying Double Indemnity right now is the first I've heard of it.
Okay.
So I don't know the history of this house.
Yeah, we'll add that stuff.
Well, should just cancel that out. Somebody should fill me, and then you can ask the question again.
No worries. Well, it's funny because I've looked at, you know, a lot of stuff online and stuff you've done with us in the past and stuff like that. You're no stranger to photo shoots, and you've done, you know, some Maxim stuff over these other things. How comfortable, how much fun do you have at these things now? Does this become old hat for you to sit down and do these kind of photo shoots?
You know, I actually love photo shoots. It's where I started. You know, I started as a model. So that was essentially the first piece that I learned how to do. So when I get to go back to that and do press for a film or a TV show and interviews and photo shoots, that's actually something I really, really look forward to when I'm doing press, is going back and reverting to this, what once was my old life, and it's fun to get back in front of a still camera as opposed to being in front of a moving one. So
now that you're a seasoned actress and have a nice, you know, resume, under your belt. When you do something like this, do you bring a different quality to it as an actress now? Is there more of a thespian thing going on?
I think, you know, provided that I've got a lot of sleep the night before, I usually show up with the same amount of excitement and looking forward to a shoot. But after having done a lot of them, I guess, to do promotions, I think it becomes more and more fun. You know, I get to work with people I've worked with before, and I love to show up at a photo shoot and see people that I've had the chance to work with before, because then you've got friends that are already there, and it's great. And then it depends on the kind of movie that you're there promoting, or TV show, and every shoot is different, which is what's the most fun, is because you never quite know what you're going to get.
Mm-hmm. You can say that about your film career too, and this movie is very different.
Yeah, with films, you never quite know what you're going to end up in. You could end up wearing a pretty dress and falling in love with Prince Charming, or being handcuffed and chased by a dog, much like me in this film we just shot.
Talk about what kind of chasing goes on and who's after you, and give people a little taste.
Gosh, what am I in? You know, the reason that I loved the script as much as I did was because when you're making a thriller and you're making a horror movie, I think the most interesting are the ones that are relatable for the key audience. And I think any woman who's ever been alone at night in a parking garage has at least had some mechanism that they use to get quickly to their car, or their own certain set way. And I always walk through with my head held high. And so I started reading the script and I thought, oh, women can relate to this fear. This is the ultimate fear, because of course it's late at night. There's nobody left because it's right before the Christmas holiday. I'm working late. You know, you're sort of layering all of these different elements on top of each other. And my car won't start, and all the lights go out in the underground parking lot. So you're, as anyone would do now, you're leading your way sort of through with the light from your cell phone. And even in the trailer, it scares the bejesus out of me, because I'm looking into my cell phone and there someone comes behind me and puts something over my mouth, and I wake up chained to a table in the office in the parking garage, and someone has changed my clothes and done my makeup, and he's serving me Christmas dinner. And from that point on, it's very much fight or flight, and Angela, my character, she fights. Thankfully, she survives, which is great.
Oh, you just gave it away.
Oh, well, come on, like they're going to kill the hero.
Talk about the fighting, because this isn't just damsel in distress. You do get to fight, and it is, you do some fun stuff in this movie.
Yeah, it was so much fun to shoot, because it's very, very physical role. And the metamorphosis that Angela goes through from the beginning, where she's very sort of prim and proper, and you can tell she's book smart, and she's well educated, and she's got a great job, and she's very put together. And by the end of the movie, she's had to fight for her own life. So this crazy, you know, she goes from everyday girl next door to this insane woman fighting for her life, which was extremely fun. And so the physicality of the role, between the running and the handcuffs, which I'll have everybody know, they were real. I never used fake cuffs. Even when I'm driving a car at one point, covered in blood, going around turns in the underground parking garage in real handcuffs. Luckily, I have gigantic hands. So. But the physicality of the movie was strenuous. It was stressful. I worked with a trainer extensively just to have the stamina to run. I mean, I'm being chased by a Rottweiler. I'm running with an axe, which was actually a real heavy axe. I'm swinging it. You know, it was a lot of fun. I get to do stuff that I hadn't had the opportunity to do.
What's like your first day like that, when you're doing that, when maybe you're a little bit into the shoot and you have that first big physical day? What's that like for you? How much fun is that? How crazy is it?
Well, the first physical day that we had in the shoot was, oh gosh, I'm scarred for life. No, I'm kidding. It sort of entailed all of the major physical aspects. I had handcuffs on. I was in the dress. They had wet down the floor of the parking garage to give it that sort of shimmer movie magic. I had to kind of roll out of a moving car and run away from the bad guy. And I rolled out of the moving car and slipped and came crashing down onto the ground. And the next day I had a huge raspberry on my leg. I had a bump on my head, and I thought, oh my God, I've got 2 months of this. So I luckily survived all 2 months, but it was not an easy feat, I will tell you that.
Are you the kind of actress where everyone knows about that, or do you just like pick it right up and get right back into it? And
usually I can pick it right up and, you know, walk it off, you know, massage it out. That, I was down for the count when I fell that time. There was screaming involved, and it was very painful. And but the bruises were really cool. We documented them. My makeup artist on the job, we took pictures of them every day because she thought, God, I've never seen so many different colors in one bruise. And I thought, oh, well, she'll remember me because of the between that and the scrapes. And we had a lot of quality time together covering up bruises, right. and then, of course, adding bruises, so...
How proud are you of getting through an experience like that? Is this movie going to be something special on your shelf afterwards? You know, you've done
I will watch things? This movie every day for the rest of my life. You know, it'll be, my brother is a big fan of horrors and thriller movies, and he is very big into MySpace as well, and they've been doing a lot of promotions on MySpace, and he's all of his friends are so excited. He's got the trailer for the movie playing on his page. He's my PR person in Maine. Evelyn, I love you, but sorry. But I get very excited about a movie when people that I know and love get excited about seeing it, and especially for my 24-year-old brother, who's really sort of hard to please. The fact that he's excited about seeing his sister in peril for an hour and a half is great.
I wonder all his friends and all the guys around the country that are excited about seeing you on the web, and how much of that do you kind of are aware of, and how much of that is just kind of fun and publicity for the movie, and how much of that do you take in?
When it's people that I know and love, when they, you know, send me a message or leave me a phone message, or my brother sends a lot of messages, you know, he's the conduit between the fans and myself, so I'll get some crazy texts that he says that he's not written, that they're from other people. And I love it. You know, anyone who's going to enjoy watching a movie that I've done or a TV show that I've done or read an article or an interview or look at pictures, I'm always flattered. I don't think that'll ever get old. I think that's one of the most rewarding parts of the process.
Mm-hmm. Now, when you were doing Alias, a lot of that action stuff was new to you. Was there a sense of some of this
being old? We have to tell them to shut that up. Hello? Don't.
You sound pretty good.
Just having already done Alias and that action stuff being a lot of that being new to you at the time a couple years back.
Yeah.
Was some of this old hat? Were there certain things, tricks you already knew that made this a little easier doing this kind of stuff, or was this all new?
You know, Alias helped me out a lot because Alias introduced me to my trainer, which I started working with Valerie as soon as I started working on Alias, and she works with Jen as well. And I kept her because, of course, I fell in love with someone telling me what to do constantly. And so when I showed up in Toronto for work, we knew ahead of time that it was going to be very physically demanding. Now, a lot of the stunts, yeah, you learn stuff quickly. You learn how to fall properly. You learn how to run without hurting yourself. You learn how to fake punch and, you know, struggle without pulling muscles, which is actually very beneficial. Because at one point, I do pretty much have Wes behind me and on my back, and we're struggling and wrestling. We end up on the floor, and those are situations in which you can get very badly hurt. But I did get hurt a couple of times, so there's no real sort of equation for making it out unscathed. But Alias definitely helped, definitely.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And you're a good actress, and Wes is a good actor. Having that kind of quality of talent, do you think that elevates this kind of movie from a mere kind of genre thing into something kind of special when you two kind of go head-to-head?
Yeah, I had always liked the script, and I liked the people involved, and as soon as they said that they were going to hire Wes, I thought, okay, great, done. I respect him and think he's extraordinarily talented, and it's a two-hander. There are really only two people in this movie, for the most part. And you, as an actor, I needed someone that I know I could trust, and that I know I could trust to perform and also to be a friend. And as soon as I met Wes, we became really, really good friends. We were shooting nights for 2 months. So that makes you a little crazy anyway. And we became really good friends, and we would joke around, and then we would show up on set, and he would scare the living daylights out of me. So that's how good he is. But yeah, no, when you bring someone like Wesson, who's obviously got a great reputation and is extremely talented, it makes my job a lot more fun and a lot easier, actually, because, like I said, he scared me.
Yeah. A lot of young women will be looking to you as a role model maybe after this as being the kind of the kick-ass hero. That's something you're looking forward to? And do you have any, like, already have advice on what to do in a parking garage?
I find it completely flattering. I love the idea of giving any, you know, girl, teenager, woman, anyone who watches the movie who thinks, oh, I could survive, then, you know, I could make it through a life or death situation kind of thing, and I could rise to the occasion. I think that's good. I think that's one of the good things the movie can do for someone. Because I certainly thought after finishing the movie, well, I could survive if someone was going to, you know, sort of knock me out in a parking garage and chain me to a desk. And you learn a lot in the movie. I don't want to give a lot of it away, but there are certain escape mechanisms that you can use. And for any of those people who love dogs, I have to warn them that no dogs were seriously wounded making this movie. But yeah, I mean, I remember when I moved to New York to go to school, and everybody said, you know, walk with your head high and walk with a purpose and look like you know where you're going. And I never unlock my car until I'm really close to it. So I get really close, unlock the car, get in, and then lock the doors again. And only unlock one door. You don't have to unlock all of them. You only have that one click and it unlocks one door. Makes it very easy.
Yeah.
That's what I suggest. And that's probably it. And learn how to run.
Yeah.
No, I'm kidding.
But there truly is a new sense of confidence now after playing this character that you can kind of handle yourself?
Yeah, I mean, the idea of I could stick someone with a fork, you know, I could do this stuff. It's things that she finds laying around, and she definitely, you know, I think in those situations, like I said, it's sort of fight or flight. She chooses to fight, and she does a pretty good job.
Very good. Now, there's a whole different kind of movie coming out just a few weeks after this one.
Yes.
If you can let us know about that. I don't think you're sticking Tom Hanks with any forks, but...
No, I'm not sticking Tom Hanks with any forks. I had a very small role in Charlie Wilson's War, which was directed by Mike Nichols and stars some people you may know, Tom Hanks and Julia Roberts and Philip Seymour Hoffman. And that was a dream come true. I mean, working on that movie with people that, obviously, even if I wasn't an actress, people that I would have been exposed to and respected no matter what my career was, and then to be able to sit down with them and have conversations. And Mike Nichols has been one of my favorite directors for years. My dad was a big fan of The Graduate, so I was exposed to Mike Nichols at a very early age. That comes out in December, and I'm not bleeding, I'm not in handcuffs, there are no dogs, there's no screaming or crying. There are tight outfits, I will say that is the one thing remains the common thread between the two. And that one's also set in the very fun 1980s.
Mm.
So you'll get to see some big hair and some bad wardrobe.
Yeah. Now, being a part of a movie like that with that kind of director and that kind of cast, are you conscious of where that can elevate your career, an Oscar quality type of movie and a performance in that film, how people can look at you now as an Oscar quality actress or being looked at as well, those types of films?
If I had a bigger role, I could probably speak of something that I could probably say, yes, of course, why not?
But
I mean, just being, the process was a very sort of humbling process because you're around these extremely talented people. And then Tom is probably one of the nicest people I've ever met. I mean, he's just the guy that you want him to be, which is it's such a relief when you meet someone that you've really loved and respected for so long, and they are extremely nice and they love everybody, and everybody loves them. And I don't think my career is going to change that much, but I think my perception of the great people in this industry has changed a lot.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Dream co-star? Just someone that you'd love to share the screen with?
Dream co-star. Dream co-star like woman, or dream
Either.
Co-star like man?
Or both.
Oh, okay. Dream co-star for a woman would probably be, I'd say, Diane Keaton. And dream co-star for a man, if it was a love interest, God, the choices. I'm going to have to say Clive Owen, which just can't help myself. Yeah, I would take those two.
Okay,
definitely.
Very good. So we hear that and it helps sometimes. So you
what?
What's
Clive, hello. yeah, no, I just saw the Queen or the Golden Age, Elizabeth, the Golden Age. I was with friends and apparently he came on and I gasped, which I wasn't really aware of.
Wow.
But those are my choices.
He's a cool guy.
Yes.
As are you. Pleasure. Pleasure talking to you.
To you.
Her
hands. We're wearing
tattoos
right
now.
And my hands.
Obvious to
look. It does, I
add.
Yeah, it does add something interesting.
Yes, with the hair.
And then on TV, it was good, like just simple. But...
last one come out?
Yep.
Chin down just a touch. Great.
Make this a lot better.
Beautiful. I'm sorry, what?
I have nothing. I was talking to me about it.
Sorry. Let's do one. Try a couple of that laugh.
No, I'm still here with you.
She's
gonna.
Yeah.
More fun stuff. Yay.
Oh, sorry. Yeah. Please, just for a sec. I'm shooting.
Should we close the door?
You can't, no.
Thank you.
Dum, 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 dum.
You gotta go see that movie now.
I know, now I'm curious.
It's a good one, so it's worth it anyways. I wanna see it, I haven't seen it in a long time.
Yeah?
So you've seen it though.
It's just like when I'm right in that doorway and.
Really?
Yeah,
I saw some shots in the house.
You'll enjoy seeing it now after doing this, yeah. I'm gonna have to pick it up this week.